What's up, Bully of the West? I'm Gabby.
And I'm Kylie, and welcome back to another episode of Owtv.
To be or not to be, that is the question.
Isn't that from Hamlet?
Yeah. Our theater program is putting on Hamlet, October 20th through 22nd, in the Flex Theater. Tickets are available at owtheater.com.
Welcome, Horatio. Welcome. So, my lord, I am too much in the sun.
Good Hamlet, cast thy knights of color off. Do not forever seek thy noble father in the dust.
Moved sooner. So,
gotcha. Hamlet, objection.
And can we make this whole formation?
I do not know, my lord, what I should think.
Mary, I will teach you.
My lord, he hath told me he...
Must I remember? She would hang on him as if increase of appetite had grown by what it fed on, and yet...
Most unnatural murder.
Murder?
Murder most foul.
Oh, haste me to... Oh, haste me to know what's where they speak to my revenge.
Wow, that looks exciting. I didn't know there was sword fighting in Hamlet.
Me either. But have you heard of Waylt-Bitteitfs?
Is that from Hamlet too?
No, it's What Are You Listening To, but it's Teacher's Edition, and it's their favorite song.
Oh, that was my next guess. Let's roll the clip.
Excuse me, Mr. Flynn. What's your favorite song?
The Immigrant Song by Led Zeppelin.
Thank you. Excuse me, what's your favorite song?
I really like Blue World by Mac Miller.
Yeah, well, this mad world made me crazy. Might just turn around to 180.
What's your favorite song?
My favorite song? Oh, it's Backstreet Boys.
Which one? Quit playing games with my heart.
Thank you. Excuse me, what's your favorite song?
Oh, wow, I'm gonna go Where the Streets Have No Name by U2.
Thank you. Excuse me, what's your favorite song?
I'm a big fan of YMCA. It really gets me going.
Thank you.
It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
I definitely agree with Mr. Flynn's favorite song.
Did you know Mr. Flynn is Olathe West Volleyball's biggest supporter?
Speaking of volleyball, since October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, the team helped out at this year's Dig Pink fundraiser. Nyla went to Olathe South to cover this important event.
The 10th annual Dig Pink Volleyball fundraiser for the Side Out Foundation was held on October 10th at Olathe South. Volleyball matches for all Olathe schools were played on two courts. This year we raised over $9,000 for breast cancer research. This event also included a silent auction, raffle items, and an honoree walk.
What an important event. And it's cool to see all five high schools join together for this cause.
The rest of our sports have also been doing great things this year. Let's take it to Emma for all the details.
Hey, All Nation, it's Emma Hale here to bring you this week's sports update. The girls' golf team finished third at the state championship earlier this week. The girls broke their own record for the fourth time this season, shooting a team score of 319. Liz Lyons and Savannah Cagle tied for fifth at the tournament. Congrats on an awesome season, ladies. The girls' tennis team finished their season a couple weeks ago at the regional match. Freshman Lindsay Reuter punched her way into state and won the first round of matches. Awesome finish on the season. The gymnastics team is sitting at the one seed to compete in the state meet tomorrow. Last week, Alexis Purdy placed second at the all-around invite. She was second in floor and beam and won bars. Gabby Klinkenbeard placed third on the floor. Good luck tomorrow, ladies. The boys' soccer team closed out their regular season Tuesday night, beating Shawnee Mission South 5-0 to move on with an overall record of 14-2. The boys are on a five-game winning streak and will host the first round of playoffs next Tuesday. Great job, boys. The cross-country team competed in the Sunflower League last Saturday. The girls came out with their fourth Sunflower League title in a row, with a 72-point difference from Olathe North coming in second place, and there were seven owls in the top 21. The boys finished sixth, and Gunnar Hornung with a 13th-place finish. Tomorrow, the team takes on regionals at Johnson County Community College. Good luck, Owls. The volleyball team has had their best season yet, standing at second in the Sunflower League with an overall record of 11-2. Their win over Shawnee Mission South last week was their 10th sweep of the season and earned the number one seed on the east side of the 6A substate bracket. The Owls host substate that starts tomorrow. Good luck, ladies. The football team is coming off a big win last Thursday against Shawnee Mission North. It was a high-scoring game, and the Owls pulled away, winning 63-41, moving to an overall record of 5-2 and standing at the fifth spot in the Sunflower League. Mason McGavran led the team with 232 rushing yards and 5 touchdowns. Tonight, the Owls face the Raiders of Shawnee Mission South for their last regular season game. Good luck, boys. That's all for this update. Good luck to all teams as they enter postseason play. Now, back to the news desk.
While on the subject of sports, the library has an amazing football display. When you go down to check it out, don't forget to say hi to our new librarian, Ms. Meyers. Kiefer brings us this report.
Olathe West has a new librarian, Mrs. Meyers. Let's get to know her. Before coming to West, Mrs. Meyers was busy raising her 4 children, and prior to that, she was even a language arts teacher.
I have been a stay-at-home mom for a long time. I have 4 kids. I was a high school language arts teacher before they were born.
Her love of reading and helping students made this the perfect job.
I love being in the high school, being around students. They're just so fun and so funny, and I like being a part of this culture.
Outside of the school day, Mrs. Meyers likes to watch students doing extracurricular activities.
I enjoy going to outside activities and getting to see kids doing what they love to do.
Some of Ms. Meyers' favorite authors include Michael J. Sullivan and Frederick Bachman. She also has a goal to instill the love of reading in West students.
For me, like my goal and my passion is for everybody to find that book that kind of speaks to them, to discover that, hey, reading is actually kind of fun.
Next time you are by the library, please stop by and say hello to Mrs. Meyers. She would love to get to know you.
Wait, Gabby, what book are you reading?
Oh, this? It's about flying planes. I've always wanted to be a pilot.
I bet you could talk to Ella's sister. I heard she's in flight school right now.
What's up, Owl Nation? It's Ella, and today I'm here with my sister.
Hi, I'm Bailey, and today we are at Kilo Charlie Aviation at New Century Airport, and I'm going to show you a little bit about what I do during the day.
Being a student here, I come in about every day to go fly with my instructor, and if I want to, which sometimes I do, we have different like study rooms where I can go in and like bring all of my computer, my iPad, and like everything I need to study. I'll just bring that in and, you know, sit in there all day and do what I need to do.
Aviation school is a place for a student to come out and learn how to fly, as well as learn a lot of regulations, learn a lot about weather, learn a lot about airplane aerodynamics, engines, electrical systems. We teach it all here.
I went to Olathe West High School. I graduated in 2021. I came to Kilo Charlie and I took a discovery flight, and then ever since that one discovery flight, I've fallen in love with aviation, and now here I am.
I wanted to go to college, so I explored some careers like engineering or even being an electrician, and then I decided kind of last minute that I wanted to go to flight school, and I found one nearby.
If you have any desire whatsoever to think about becoming a pilot, don't hesitate, come out and see us.
Come try it out, see if aviation is something for you, see if there's a field out there. There's lots of different things out there besides four-year universities.
It's something that you will have the rest of your life. I got mine at the age of 22, and I'm 64 now, and I'm still flying.
Come and take a discovery flight. No one knows what they want to do, so don't worry about it. It's okay. Everything will be okay.
I think I'll leave the flying up to you.
I'll take flying if you take scuba diving. Adam Porter brings us a story on a student at Olathe West who loves exploring the depths of the sea.
Students at Olathe West have varied interests. One such student, Kendall Hughes, has an interest in scuba diving.
Ever since I was 11, I've been now certified to scuba dive in up to 75 feet of water.
At an early age, Kendall loved swimming and diving.
When I was a little girl, my dad and my sister both wanted to start scuba diving because we went to a nearby lake, and me and my sister kept diving down to the bottom and trying to check out a bunch of cool stuff that was on the very, very bottom of the lake. My dad sent us to Midwest Aquatics, which is a scuba diving facility. and we took a week-long class. We took our license test in Table Rock Lake.
Kendall loves to explore the depths of different bodies of water, including shipwrecks.
My favorite part is definitely exploring shipwrecks, a bunch of abandoned ruins, all that type of stuff. I've been to 5 different dive sites. I've been doing this from 6 to 7 years, and we go scuba diving every summer, try to at least.
What an amazing story. Thanks, Kendall, for sharing your hobby with us.
That is so cool. I wonder if she has found any sunken treasure.
I know. She should explore Olathe Lake. Maybe she can retrieve my iPhone I lost this summer.
Maybe. But let's end this episode first.
Yes. Lots of sports this weekend. Go cheer on the football team at Shawnee Mission tonight. And the volleyball team hosts regionals at West tomorrow.
And our very own Gabby and the gymnastics team is competing for a state title tomorrow at Olathe South. Good luck and bring home the gold.
Thanks. And that's all for this episode. Have a great weekend.
Bye.